Hello everyone, and welcome to another laser scanner test for the archives of the YouTube. This time we're going to test what a simple, humble Scotch Brite kitchen sponge can do for our bowling ball. Why, you might say? Because it's fun and it's cheap. So let's do it. I'm going to scan a shiny bowling ball. This one happens to be a pearl. We're going to scan it twice to get our baseline grit numbers. So 5,189 on the first scan. I scan it slicing the ball in different angles so that we are sure that it has the same surface everywhere. In the end, I will also scan it twice at the same angles. We want to be as much as scientific as possible with these things. And here we have 5,200. Great, so even surface all around. We have our regular Scotch Brite, the one we use for our kitchen. And I usually use a bit of water with abalones, so I will add a bit here too. In order to compare things on the scanner, I use a standard method of resurfacing done by hand, which is 30 seconds for each half of the ball. So I'm going to do some circular motions on the side of the ball and then on top of it for about 30 seconds, and then I'm going to flip it over and repeat. All this is done with moderate pressure. It would be nice if everyone did it this way, because in that case we could compare each person's experience. But how do you resurface your bowling ball by hand? Do you even pay attention? Because most people don't, and they just continue to surface the ball until it kind of looks dull by sight. Tell me in the comments below. I'm kind of interested in how you do it. Feels a bit weird doing it with a kitchen pad, but I am curious. Okay, so there's not much on the pad, but it has large gaps, so we'll see. The ball does look duller here, even to the naked eye. It has some scratches as well, so. Which is, that's good, means that the pad actually did something. Okay, let's see what we did. We began with 5,200 roughly, and now we have Okay, we have an area here that is duller. It happens sometimes. But the overall grit is a grit average is 4005. Not bad at all. So from 5200 we went to 4000. Now let's check the second area that we scanned before, which was also 5200. It should be somewhere around 4000. All right. Looks similar. This one is 3716. Pretty close. So we got about 12 to 1500 grit reduction and thus more teeth on the ball. They're starting from a very shiny 5200. That's cool. Actually, there is some material that I can see now on the Scotch Brite pad. Alright, and now you know what a simple Scotch Brite can do. For example, you can use it to take all of the shine off your bowling ball without making it very dull at all. Another reason that this experiment is useful. A 3000 or 4000 CTD pad, which would do the same job, costs from 10 to 20 times as much as this Scotch Brite. So you would need the CTD pad to outlast the Scotch Brite pad about or 10 to 20 times just to have the same value. And based on my CTD performance test that I did some time ago, and you can check at the end of the video, I don't see that happening. Of course, someone might say that the Scotch Brite may have the same short durability as the CTD pad. Well, in that case, the Scotch Brite is simply 10 to 20 times cheaper. So, good to know. And now you got some more bowling XP. Thanks for watching and see you on the next one. Bye.